Deryck, some 41. How are you? All right?
I'm good, yeah.
Welcome to London.
Thank you. It's nice weather.
Yeah, well, thank you. I think you've sort of brought it with you, really.
Probably.
Yeah. So what have you been up to? And what brings you to London today?
Well, we've been over in Europe for the past couple of weeks on tour, doing festivals and a couple headlining shows, and we were pretty close by, so we decided to come by.
Yeah, good. Well, thanks for dropping by. It's nice to see you. I've been having a little nose, actually. I had a look on your website. There's some footage of you out in Europe. You've been playing loads of big festivals, haven't you?
Yeah.
And how's that gone?
It's been really great. Yeah, the crowds have been awesome. The response has been amazing. You know, we've been away for a while, so you're never really sure what to expect, and it's been better than we could imagine.
Well, it appears to me that the fans have really missed you.
It seems like it. You know, like I said, we didn't know what to expect, but people have been excited.
Well, were you surprised by the response?
I mean, like I said, you just never really know, you know. It's sort of, I would say, pleasantly surprised.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think you spoke as well. I mean, because the fan base as well, I mean, I never really think about this, but of course, especially European fan base, there is, you know, on occasion, a bit of a language barrier. Mm-hmm. I know that English is, you know, primarily the second most language in the world or whatever, but I never really take that into account. But you raise a good point, you know, that the music seems to sort of cross, you know, through language, doesn't seem to matter.
It does. And I guess I never really realized it until this tour as well, that after this many years and these songs, that when I meet people, you know, when I meet fans and stuff, and they say how much these songs mean to them, and it surprises me when English isn't their first language.
Yeah, and nice to see as well that the music still resonates as well, because, you know, first time around, what sort of year was it? Were we talking here for you guys when it all sort of exploded for you?
2001.
Mm-hmm. So, you know, we're talking 15 years ago. Mm-hmm. And those songs to still have their place and resonate with the fan base now, it's great, isn't it?
Everyone still jumps at Fat Lip.
they do. Yeah. Even I do, even with my dodgy back, which I did because I saw you in Manchester, because that was sort of, it was the Kerrang tour earlier this year, of course, which was great. But to see so many people, you know, obviously buying the tickets, the sellout shows coming down and loving you 15 years later, it sort of said to me, wow, you guys really are sort of back with a bang.
It feels like it. I mean, it feels better than ever, to be honest. It's the crowds have been more enthusiastic. The shows sell out faster. You know, everything's been bigger and better this time around.
Yeah, I was pogoing in Manchester, I must admit, and then I had to go and lie down for a week, which is what happens as you get closer to 40, turns out. I mean, those dates really sort of herald the return of some 41 for me. And now, of course, we've got the new record, 13 Voices, which is coming out in October. Obviously, you're very pleased, very proud of that record. Mm-hmm. And from what I understand, it's quite obviously a cathartic album for you in many ways.
It was. I mean, I wrote every song was, you know, every record is always sort of a snapshot of who I am at that period of my life. And this was at a period of my life which was really difficult. I was going through recovery from liver and kidney failure. I just got out of the hospital. I was newly sober. There's all this self-doubt and insecurity and finding these new feelings and emotions for the first time and writing songs sober for the first time. So everything was new and everything was a learning process and everything was was a struggle. So all of that sort of came out in this record.
I mean, we've had a couple of songs from it, and the most recent, which, you know, is just dropped, so to speak, is a track called War, which... In particular, I'm guessing from what I've heard, is that the most sort of self-exploratory one for you?
It was like the most important song for me at a time that was sort of a tipping point period of in my recovery, because I'd been, you know, on this road to recovery for about a year now, which seemed like it was not getting any better. I didn't seem to have any progress. I couldn't walk. I couldn't, I wasn't writing songs. It just seemed like I was never getting better. I was never getting close to where I was trying to get to. And I could have easily just fallen off the wagon at that point and just said, you know, this is never going to happen. The doctors were saying they didn't know if I was ever going to recover. And I wrote these lyrics just randomly. They just sort of came to me. And once I had written these lyrics, I realized it was sort of like my battle cry in a way. It was like everything that I was trying to do and wanted to do. And when I had written it all, I felt like, well, I've got these words now. I have to live up to it. You know, I've got the song now. It'd be silly if I don't keep pushing and fighting. So once I had that, it sort of reminded me. Every time I had those moments of self-doubt, I would read those lyrics, and it helped me push forward.
So the war was, I mean, it was literally that with the booze.
Yeah, it was a war within myself. And you know, and I'm glad I stuck with it, because it did take about 2 years to finally fully recover. And, you know, at that point, it didn't get any easier. It just gave me some, you know, more inspiration, I guess, to keep fighting.
Well, it's a very powerful record, and I think that really comes across, not only when you listen to it for the first time, but then if you actually go back and you watch the video that you've done with it as well, and then it makes even more sense. Because for people that don't know, I mean, you're essentially walking through an airplane graveyard, aren't you?
Yeah.
And then you sort of dig up relics of the past. You know, it might be your old skateboard or your Vans, and then there's a bottle of Jack, and then you torch it all at the end.
Yeah.
Which I thought was a nice touch. Why did you torch the skateboard, though? I would have kept that.
Well, the same reason why you say you don't jump anymore, getting closer to 40.
This is true. All of a sudden, those stairs and, you know, doing the ollie, it's not so appealing, is it?
No. Face plants aren't cool when you're 40.
Exactly. But it's a very powerful video and a really powerful song as well. Cool. So that must be one you're particularly proud of, I would think.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, it was, like I said, it was an important song for me in my recovery, which is why I wanted it to be a single. Mm-hmm. You know, it's probably one of the only, say, slower songs on the record. The record's more of a rock record. It's upbeat and it's aggressive, and that was sort of the say, ballad, if you will, on the record.
Well, it took me by surprise when I saw the title. I thought, oh, this is going to be lively.
I know, right?
And then it's not, but it's a beautiful thing. So congratulations with that one.
Cool, thank you.
And also, you know, congratulations with the recovery as well, because you look great. You really do.
Thanks.
You know, because we all saw the pictures, everything that's posted online, and it, you know, I mean, we all felt for you, but now you're looking really tip top, which is amazing to see.
Cool, thanks.
So what's next for you? I mean, obviously, I've written it down because I liked it so much. The Don't Call It a Sunback Tour.
Yeah.
Who thought of that?
You know what? I think that came from Cone, actually.
Okay. My kind of humor.
We were all just coming up with different names, you know, funny names. Everyone had a few, and then that was the best one. But that's in the fall. That starts in North America. I mean, that's going to be pretty much like the tour name of the, you know, this album, at least, you know, for the first part of it anyway.
Okay. Was that North America?
That was North America, okay. But we're planning on coming in the new year back to Europe.
Okay, that was going to be my next question.
Yeah.
Fantastic.
January, February is what we're looking at to lock that in.
Unconfirmed as yet, but
it's unconfirmed, but that's what we're trying to make happen.
All right, brilliant. Well, listen, congratulations with everything. It's a great record. You know, the tracks that I've heard so far, and obviously 13 Voices coming out in October. Would you like to play the new single? We can slot it in right now if you fancy. Would you like to introduce it?
Sure. Hey, everybody, check out our new song. It's called War.